All right, good afternoon. It's the 10th of July, middle of the afternoon, and Matt Wright's here.
Jeremy Elliott.
And today is Saturday, so we're going to get going on a few videos here. We just started talking on the first video, got 3 minutes in, and I'm filming on my BlackBerry, and a call came in from my boy Reggie. He's up in Pamunkey Regional Jail up in Hanover. You know, I've just written him a letter, and then he gave my new number. I just put $50 on him. He called the first time. I put $50 on his phone. They got the prepaid phone thing that you can call. So I put $50 on his account online so he could call me. $1.03 a call, which is bad. At least they don't have to call a collection anymore. That's the way it used to be. You know, that's something I'm going to touch on. We got a lot of things we can touch on, but keeping it real is real important to us. And, you know, I've been locked up before a lot of different times. So was Jeremy. Back in our days, you know, I was strung out as strung out of a crackhead and fucking speed addict and a dope fiend and a lot of stuff. An alcoholic, a pothead, tripper. I don't know. Pill popper, none of the drugs I really haven't done. You know, I just really burnt myself out back then, spent a lot of time ripping people off and just doing crazy shit, you know, stealing and getting high all the time, just supporting the habits. And just back all through the 90s. But these days we clean ourselves up, we've gotten our shit together. But thanks to NA, you know, I'm an NA. I've been going to NA for several years now.
AA too.
And AA and NA. It's Narcotics Anonymous, Alcoholics Anonymous. But it's a lot of it's self-discipline beyond that too. Maybe self-discipline.
I was going to say the infinite. You know,
the infinite helps us too. But I feel bad when I see people locked up no matter what they've done. I know how it is. You know, like people forget you. Believe me, they do. You know, you write people, they don't write back. People hang up when you call. They don't want to spend a dollar to take a call.
Yeah.
You know, it's, and I always swore, like, that I was going to do better for people, you know, when I had people I knew were locked up, you know. So, and I do, you know, I just spent $50, and I don't mind spending $50 on putting that on his book to get the phone working. He didn't even ask. I wanted to do it. Wanted to talk to my boy, you know, but because for anybody, I got no other people locked up, you know. I mean, I write them, I do my best I can to keep it real, you know. Gotta show love to everybody everywhere. But let's get back to where we were on the first video before phone rang with Reggie, and then the video we lost part of the first video 3 minutes in the phone rang, but I switched the phone off this time, so I won't interrupt the video this time. Switch the whole thing off, so no calls will come in. Just goes to voicemail. But anyway, we're talking about a comment I put up earlier on our Facebook page regarding that, you know, that we deal mostly with violent death and spirits who've been murdered a lot of the time, mostly young people, you know, mostly males. And we try to deal with a lot of people from the Richmond area, since we live here. So we're going to start with that.
Right.
But I put a comment saying that pretty much if whoever's you've seen around that's died violent deaths in the past 8 months, 12 months, and around Richmond, chances are we've talked to your loved ones. Yeah. You know, we've talked to plenty of those spirits. And
we communicate
with all of them.
And I also wanted to say, you know, touch on, you know, it doesn't have to only be recent spirits. It can definitely be spirits from the past. You know, somebody wrote us, you know, about a spirit in 99.
Just today. Yeah. He died in 99. Oh, this guy was murdered in 1999. Fall of 99.
Yeah. And of course, we can communicate with them.
He came right through. You know, he took his seat. He came immediately through. He didn't take any effort.
You know, wanted her to answer, you know, ask questions. He was ready to answer questions, you know.
Yeah. They're we're supposed to get up with that lady and their family. We'll hopefully get up and talk to y'all. You know, y'all know who you are.
Yeah.
If you're watching this, we'll get up with y'all very soon. You're
sure.
You got people that want to talk to you, not just him, I think, as other ones. But anyway, don't hesitate to call us, you know, or write us. I mean, because this is what we do this for. We do it for free because, like, a lot of people have deaths in the family through murder in Richmond, and a lot of it happens with young people. A lot of it happens in the hood, you know, and over various things, not all of it. And sometimes people need help. I mean, a lot of everyone needs help, you know, something that doesn't matter if you're black or white, or if you're young or old, or male or female.
Rich or poor.
It's this rich or poor, there's pain. Yeah, there's pain that's resulted to things like this, and we're here to heal that pain. So, you know, whatever it takes, we're here to help. So, you know, just gotta let us know. Just get in touch with us, because...
Yeah, ask questions, and always have to say we do the best we can, you know, to answer them back. You know, we're trying to think about, you know, new ideas and things to talk about and do on the video, so if you have any comments or ideas, you know, send them to, you know, we'll accept anything, you know.
That's right.
You know, we're just open to whatever, and we're trying to help people heal, you know.
That's right. So much pain going on, there's so much going on out there. And I mentioned before how much we enjoy talking to younger people.
Yeah.
A teenager, stuff like that, even sometimes younger. It really is good to talk to y'all, you know.
Absolutely.
I mean, y'all are losing friends too, and it's kind of, I know it hurts. And you can't just always bury that pain within you. You know,
yeah,
it doesn't make you more of a man to hold all the pain in and stuff. It doesn't make you more manly. You know, it's going to hurt you more.
Yeah, it's very natural to express yourself in the way you feel at the moment, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It may not always, you know, be the best turnout for you or whatever, but especially how you feel is how you feel. You know, there's nothing that can change that, you know, except for yourself.
That's right. Like if you're male and then you find yourself feeling upset or finding tears in your eyes or thinking about a friend who's died, I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. Go ahead and go with what you feel. You know, don't. I mean, the world might judge that saying you're weak or a pussy or men don't cry or you're a faggot because you're crying or shit like that, but it's not true, you know.
You don't have to be anything.
You ain't no less of a man. You ain't no less of a thug or anything else that it might be, you know, because of that. Like, somebody said thugs cry too. That's a song lyric.
Yeah.
So I'm just thinking about a thug cry. I forgot when thugs cry. It's some song lyric I heard.
I've heard something like that, but it makes sense, you know.
It's something like that. I forgot who wrote the song, but... You know, thugs cry
sensitive,
too, or geez,
and Jay-Z says, sensitive thugs all need hugs.
Right, yeah. I remember you mentioning that before. Sensitive thugs need hugs.
Yeah.
That's true, you know. It's the truth in that,
And, you know, some of us are very sensitive, you know. What did I say? I was quoting another song, actually, by Traveling Wilburys, you know. Some people need to be handled with care. You know, handle me with care is how the song lyric went. But a lot of people, you know, they can seem like they're in huge situations, you know, but they do need to be handled with a sensitive hand, you know, handle with care, you know.
Yeah.
A lot of people need that.
We do our best to handle everything with care.
Yeah.
You know, we try not to come off as rough or what's a good word?
Scary or
Over-assertive. We're just being ourselves, you know?
Yeah, we just...
You see us talking lightheartedly about death and all, because it is to us. I mean, it's just no big deal to us. It's like, because we see the big picture, it's no big deal.
Well, we don't understand the naturality of feeling the emotions.